how to import products into your form. Follow me to my desktop right now. Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to JotForm. My name is George, and on this video, I am going to show you how to import your products into your form. That means that you'll be able to sell your products that you import from a CSV, from WooCommerce, Shopify, even QuickBooks, from practically anywhere you want. So let me go ahead and get started. So this is my main dashboard, and we're gonna get started with a brand new form where we are going to add the product list option. So let's go ahead and create a form. Let's go ahead and start from scratch. We're gonna use the classic form. And in this case, we're gonna drag in that element, okay? Now be aware that you can build the form as complex as you like, but in this case, we're just gonna add the product list option, okay? That way we know how to import. Now, to get into that option, we're gonna click on the shopping cart here, which is the product list. And we have this option that says import. We're gonna go ahead and click on this, and we have six available options, which I'm going to show you right now how to use each one of these. Okay, so let's get started with the first one, which is CSV or Excel. Now, the first thing I would recommend is that you download the example. The reason for this is because it's going to show you how to structure the way you're going to add your products in the CSV. Okay, so let's go ahead and open up this CSV right now. Here we go. And we can see here that we have a column for products, a column for price, description, the image URL, and the available stock. The idea here is that you add in the same column your products and then import it into this JotForm importer option, because this is the way it needs to be structured. Okay, so you add your products right here with the details, and you can go ahead and copy and paste from somewhere else if you got an Excel sheet that is not structured this way, and go ahead and then import it. Now in this case, I have already downloaded this and I'm ready to go. So I'm gonna go ahead and search for it in my folder. I'm going to select, in this case, my sheet option here, which is not a CSV, but it's practically the same, okay? So it's now doing the import process. It's gonna tie the Excel sheet in this case to my product field. So in this case, we can see here that it understands that the name is tied with the title, description with description, URL with the image in this case. But you can see here, for example, available stock. It's reading this title from the Excel. I can go ahead and select here. And if in case it gets it wrong, I can go ahead and select it from here. But in this case, it's all correct. Stock to stock, price to price, etc. If something is wrong, to go ahead and change that structure. If you don't need something, go ahead and click on the X and remove it. In this case, we're good to go. Let's go ahead and review and import. Okay, again, reviewing here, we got the title, description, making sure that everything is fine. Images, stock, and price, we're good to go. Let's go ahead and start the import process. Now, be aware that we right now have one product as a demo product, but now we have all these products available that we're ready to go and start using. So that's one of the ways that you can import your products. Let's go into the next option. Let's go into import, and we can import from a PDF. Now, what it's going to do, it's going to read the PDF and it's going to grab the details for your products and import it. Okay, so let's go ahead and test it out. Let's go ahead and go into my computer, and I'm going to use this one. Here we go. It has a title, some prices, some products, etc. Let's go ahead and open this up. And again, it's going to read the PDF, understand how it's structured, so we can go ahead and import those products into this. So let's give it a few seconds. Here we go. It's now ready. We have the title, description. In this case, we don't read the images or stock, but we do have the prices. I don't have any stock on that PDF. It's because it's a PDF. But the cool thing about this is that you can use this, for example, if you have a menu, if you have a PDF from other products, go ahead and import it really easily right here. So let's go ahead and kick off the import option here. And we should be getting those products over here that have been added. Here we go, three products. So we got sneakers, the backpack, and the smartwatch, with their price, their title, and description really easily right here. Okay, so next option, let's go to import. We're gonna do via image. So this is a pretty cool option because you can actually, I'm gonna use this one. So you can see I got some images here with prices and description. I'm going to open this up and it's gonna start reading the actual image. So the cool thing about this is that, for example, if you go to a website and you don't have access to the CSV, Excel file, PDF, etc., grab a screenshot and bring it inside of here, and it's gonna read it with this image, okay? So here we go, we got the title, description, and we have the price here. So let's go ahead and import this, and it's just super easy to import via image because It's just so flexible. So here we go. Those products have now been added and they are right here. Pretty cool, right? Okay, next option, via Shopify. So via Shopify, we're able to bring in the CSV. To do that, let's go into our Shopify store. And currently I'm inside of my demo store here. I am gonna go into the products tab here. And in this section, I'm gonna highlight these and I am going to export. I'm gonna export this and I have the option to export the current page, which is what I'm doing right now. All the products, in this case, if you have hundreds of products or more than 20, et cetera, what you're viewing in the page, go ahead and select all products or just the selected ones and export as a CSV for Excel or a plain CSV. So both options will work really easily. So let's go ahead and export the products. Here we go. I am going to say test for this. Let's go into job form. Let's go ahead and add that CSV that we just brought from Shopify store. And here we go. Again, it's tying the elements with the elements from the product field. Okay. So here we go. We got the body HTML with the product description, title with title, image with image, variant grams, stock, etc. We're good to go. Let's go ahead and review and import. Here we go. Here's the details. And we're good to go. Let's go ahead and import this. And remember, this was brought from Shopify. So you grab all those details over there and bring it inside of here. So we're good to go. And we got the two SD cards now here in our stock. Okay, let's go to the next option. Let's go to import. Let's view the WooCommerce option. In WooCommerce, you have two options to bring in products. You got the API credentials and the CSV. Let's get started with the credentials, which is super easy. Okay, let's go into our WooCommerce store. In this case, this is my WooCommerce store. And the first thing we need to do is go to WooCommerce. We're going to go into settings. And in settings, we're going to go into the advanced tab. And in the advanced tab, we are going to go into REST API. In this case, let's go ahead and add a brand new key. There we go. I'm going to name this job form so I can locate it later on. And in this case, I'm going to say delete because I'll be deleted afterwards. Be aware that you need to not share this information with other people. Okay? We're going to allow read and write. We're going to generate the API key. And here we go. We got our details. Let's go ahead and copy the consumer key. Let's bring it inside of here. Let's grab the consumer secret. There we go. And the website URL. So in this case, let me go ahead and grab my link right here, which is a demo website. So let me go ahead and copy this. Bring it over here and we're good to go. Let's go ahead and continue. If everything is fine, it will make the connection and read the products that I have on my website. In this case, again, we're going to tie the fields, making sure that everything is correct. But you can see that it's already titled with the title, description with the description, and they go along one with another. If not, go ahead and click the drop down menu and select the correct one to be tied. Okay. And if you don't need something, just go ahead and remove it. All right. So we're good to go. Let's go ahead and review and import. Here we go. We got a demo here. We're good to go. Let's go ahead and import this. And we should have those products added here really easy. Here we go. Let's scroll down here. And again, we got the SD cards, which is what I use for the demo side. Let's go ahead and import again. And there's a final option, which is QuickBooks. I don't have QuickBooks, but again, all you have to do is export the Excel file from QuickBooks and bring it inside of here and import your products, which is super easy. You can see that you have several available options to import your products without having to manually creating each one of these, which would be really time consuming to do it manually. So these are fantastic options to import your products. So please let me know here in the comments what you think about the import options here on JotForm and what you would like to see in the future. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification to get notified when new videos come out. And that is a wrap.